Hey everyone, welcome back to another tutorial from monocrysellers.com. Today I'm going to show you how to flash a firmware on the Samsung S25 series using Odin, and more importantly, how to avoid the common errors that cause the phone to flash and soft brick your device. If you flashed Samsung phones before and tried the same method on the S25, you probably run into the issue where it stops at super image and gives you a red message on the phone. Download failed due to incompatible download program. Please try again with the latest version. Your first guess might be to look for a newer version of Odin, but unfortunately, there isn't one. Don't worry, in this video I'll walk you through the correct method that works. Let's get started. First, you'll need the correct firmware for your phone. The easiest way is to go to samfw.com. Just type in your exact model number, for example SMS936U, and download the firmware for your model with the same bit number or newer. If you're not sure about the bit version, check the fifth character of the baseband version in your phone settings or in recovery mode. But in most cases, downloading the latest firmware for your model will work fine. Next, you'll need Odin version 3.14.4. This is the latest version, and I'll leave the link in the description below. Older patched versions like 3.14.1 also work, but I recommend using the most updated one just in case. Make sure you run Odin as administrator to avoid permission issues. While we wait for the firmware to download, it's a big file, so it will take some time, let's prepare the phone. To enter download mode, power off the phone. Then press and hold volume up and volume down, and while holding, connect the USB cable to your PC. You'll see a blue warning screen. Now press volume up again and you'll reach to the full download screen. At this point, the phone should appear in Device Manager as Samsung modem, and Odin will detect it as a green COM port. Once the firmware is downloaded, extract it using 7-zip or any other archive tool. You'll get several files, BL, AP, CP, CSC, and sometimes user data. Now here's the important part. Open the CSC file using 7-zip and extract the PIT file from inside. Copy it to the same folder you have the firmware files. This PIT file is what will make the flash actually work on the S25. Without it, Odin won't be able to flash critical partitions like super image. Now let's load the files into Odin. BL goes into the BL slot, CP goes into CP. For CSC, use home CSC if you want to keep your data, or use regular CSC for a clean flash. AP goes into AP, this may take some time to load, and Odin might freeze or sometimes say not responding. Don't panic, just wait. User data is optional and mostly used for carrier branding. You can skip it if it's not needed. Now for the most important step. Go to Options tab and check Repartition. Then click the PIT button and select the PIT file you extracted earlier. Once everything is set up and the phone is still in download mode, press Start. The flashing process will begin, and this time it won't freeze on super image or give you any errors. When it finishes, the phone will reboot and you'll be good to go. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe and share it with others. And for the best unlock services and professional GSM tools, check out unlockresellers.com. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.